Hi, my name is Lisa Lingso. I'm right now at Bali, and as a futurist, I really see clearly that we have two scenarios that are going in two completely opposite directions. One is creating nature using technologies, new means of communication, new means of artificial intelligence in order to inform us how to treat nature better and to get more biodiversity and how to live in closer proximity to nature, for instance by placing nature back in to urbanized spaces, the advent of driverless car moving on electricity, they can drive away, we don't need the parking lots anymore. So that's one scenario, and I've just been visiting Green School here in Bali, which is by the way also opening in Mexico, in South Africa and Canada, and it's basically teaching kids all the way for 12 years all the way to high school on how to learn languages, understanding the environment, learning math, but also producing their own food and sustainable energy. So that's one scenario where when we look back 10 years from now, we become far more in tune with nature than ever before. The other scenarios is really one that I experienced very close by in Dubai. In January, I was visiting a client and we were drowning in rain because they thought it had been a very dry season, so they did what they call cloud seeding, and that is basically putting chemicals into the clouds with 9 airplanes, and then you had this huge thunderstorm, lots and lots of rainfall. So basically everybody were sliding around, the planes were delayed for 3 days, so it went a little over the top. In our cockpit, the window was actually smashed by a bit of ice, so heavy stuff, but also an interesting signal that, well, the weather, we just decide how the weather should be. Digging CO2 into the ground, catching CO2 in the atmosphere, and using any means to try to create the nature that we need. So for instance, building vertical gardens, not needing the soil at all. You will be able to harvest 4 times a day. I'll put you a link to Next Food, which is the perfect way to feed an urban village. And also you will have lab-grown meat. We'll think back and say, did we really kill these poor animals? What were we thinking about? You know, you can have a perfect steak grown out of a lab, so why should you let animals go through all these pains and hassles? What is interesting with this artificial scenario, I think, is that if we don't need nature anymore, what will we do to it? Is it going to be this huge tourist area? You can see that tourism is growing more than any other business at the moment. Or are we just going to kill off nature because we don't need it anymore? I mean, we don't really have horses now that we don't need horses but use cars. So that's a very interesting question for the future as well. So in this hot letter, it's all about, are we moving into a more artificial sort of future with where we really do not need nature as we did before? Are we using technology to get back to nature? For instance, in the Asian countries, doctors are actually paid for keeping people well. That's their tradition that they bring in, where in the westernized world, it's the hospitals taking the money once people have gotten ill. So many different mindsets out there, and it's going to be very interesting to see the development. My last point to the artificial future is a friend of mine, he's a heart doctor, and he said, Lisa, you might think that I have a very meaningful job, but actually I spent 90% of my time reviving these old age folks in their 80s and 90s, even 100 years old, because people are not any longer allowed to die from a heart attack. You know, so we keep them alive and then I get them back again 2 months later and the quality of life sucks. So is this really the future that we are heading into? So interesting, exciting. How do you think our society is going to develop if we look at ourselves from the moon? Is it going into a more natural way, or is it going into an artificial nature direction? See you.